tomorrow. I already did that yesterday and the day before that and the day before that, and it's already day after tomorrow. And if I wait any longer, it'll be next week before sundown. Goodbye. Hey, Wes. Forget about that car and go over to Emmitsville and pick up that shipment of tires I ordered last week.
Emmitsville?
Order something for over here and they send it over there. Order it for over there and they send it here. If I had sense enough to pound sand into a rat hole, I wouldn't have ordered it in the first place.
Gee, Mr. Stott, if I have to go clear over to Emmitsville, I'm not going to make it back
in time for your birthday party. Yeah, I know.
Well, you promised me I'd get off early today.
It's only 8 miles. 10 minutes to go, 10 minutes to load, 10 minutes to come back. 30 minutes. Now, where did I put that doggone... Oh.
Yeah, but I have to go to the cleaners. I won't have anything to wear at the party tonight.
Here.
I've got to go to the bookstore and pick up that corsage for Irene.
Better put gas in the pickup.
Well, that darn girl. She's called here once, she's called a million times. Be sure and plan it so Wes can get off early for his...
without frames. Dirty dishes.
Nora, come on in.
Beethoven on the bed. Meyer back in the bathroom. I gotta get out. Hey, you wanna come along?
Come along where?
Oh, I don't care.
Outdoors. Oh, those walls are closing in on me.
I'd love to, but I've got tons of things to do. I have to make the punch, get the hors d'oeuvres ready.
Oh, you want some help?
No, I think everything's under control.
Well, I was hoping you'd say that. Now, that's interesting. What do you call it?
An abstract cake design? I call it a disaster. Now I'm going to have to scrape it all off and start all over again.
Oh, no, you don't. What?
But... Hello?
Hi, honey. I know you're probably busy, but I've been waiting all week for a back issue of the Harvard Law Review.
The bookstore just called to say that it was in.
You want me to pick it up for you?
Well, I'd get it myself, but I have to go to Amazonville for a load of tires.
That's okay. I have time.
Good.
It's a July 1957 issue.
Honey?
July?
1957.
That's all right. I'll drop it by at the station as soon as I can.
I should be back in about 30 minutes. I'll see you then.
I'll be here. Bye-bye.
There.
That's beautiful, Nora. Really beautiful.
Well, you can still scrape it off and start over again.
What are you kidding? I wouldn't think of it.
I don't lie. Well, I'm sorry you won't come with me.
Boy, sure off I get back before the cleaners close.
Don't worry, you've got plenty of time.
To load the tires and 10 to get back. 50 minutes and I'm not back yet.
What are you doing way out here?
I'm waiting for a streetcar.
Well, why don't you get down?
And rip my new Christian Dior.
Oh. Here, I'll help you.
Be careful, because it's kind of sticky up here.
Ow!
Okay. How'd you get out here, anyway?
I walked.
All the way from town?
No, all the way from those hills.
Well, where's your car?
Well, it's sulking. It screamed at me and spit at me and then just sat there.
Well, how far away is it, anyway?
Oh, about, Four Robins, a Scarlet Tanager, Block of Wild Geese Way.
Up this road?
Mm-hmm. There is the wildest field of goldenrod up there.
Let's see. The cleaners don't close until 6. Okay, we might as well go have a look at it. You can't be too far away if you walk. Didn't you see that sign?
What sign?
Never mind.
Hi, Mr. Stott. Quite back yet?
No, but he will be, Irene. Don't worry. He's not going to be late for his doggone birthday party. I never could understand why people want to celebrate being 1 year closer to the grave. Oh, as long as you just stand around doing nothing, maybe you better take this over to Dobson's and get it changed.
Yes, sir.
Nobody ever has anything a little smaller than a 20 anymore except me.
What time Wes is coming back?
Anytime, I guess. He told me he'd be back in half an hour.
When was that?
An hour and 20 minutes ago.
How much farther do we have to go, anyway?
Ah!
What's the matter?
Look, that huge flash of colored lichen. Hey, what does that suggest to you? Right off the top of your head.
Residents only. Keep out.
Well, that's interesting. Why?
That sign.
Well, that's us. Residents of the world. Let's go.
Oh, boy.
Irene, answer that darn phone, will you? Probably Wes, anyway.
Oh, okay.
What about that change I sent you after?
Here it is.
Darn phone company. Think they're so smart. Why can't they figure out a way to ring the phone without making any noise?
Start service. I'm sorry, he's busy right now. May I take a message, please? Who? I'll tell him. Mr. Stott?
I'm busy. Find out what he wants.
He wants to talk to you.
Who?
A Mr. Winthrop from the auto supply company.
Who?
Mr. Winthrop.
I don't know any Winthrop. What's his first name?
Scotty.
What?
Scotty!
Why didn't you say so? Take the message.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry, Mr. Winthrop. Mr. Stott can come to the phone right now. May I help you? No, Wes isn't here either. But we're expecting him back any minute. Excuse me, Mr. Stott. Mr. Winthrop says it has something to do with the bill you haven't paid.
What bill?
Well, it has something to do with some auto parts.
Auto parts?
He says he sent you some parts last month and you haven't paid for them.
I did, too. What parts?
Two unwound generators.
Rewound.
A hot gas bypass valve.
They sent the wrong size.
5 pounds of body grease?
What?
Body grease. Half dozen oil pump nipples, a pair of brake shoes, and a set of feminine rackets.
What?
I think that's what he said. Feminine rackets.
Never heard of feminine rackets or ratchets. It's not feminine, it's female. Female ratchets, and I ordered male. Here, give me that thing. Not that thing, that thing. There, now get out. Come on, get out. Get out, get out, get out, get out. Hello, Gunny. I'm coming right over and talk to you. We'll straighten this thing out. Yeah. Dang phone. Can't tell what a man's saying if you can't see his face. How can you argue with someone that isn't there?
Mr. Stott, who's going to take care of the station?
Just keep an eye on it. Wes will be back pretty soon.
Mr. Stott, I...
How'd you manage to get a crosswise like that?
I was turning around. Boy, how can you drive on a road like that?
No wonder you can't move. Your rear wheels are off the ground.
Why do things like this always happen to me?
Well, this certainly is my lucky day. It isn't the first time I've ever run out of gas, but it's certainly the first time I've been able to coast into a gas station.
Hi.
Hello. Where is everybody?
Oh, well, Mr. Stott just went up the street for a minute, and Wes is over in Emmisville picking up some tires.
Oh, I see.
Well, I'm sure one of them will be back in a few minutes.
Well, it looks like I'll just have to wait. Floyd warned me if I used his car, I'd better put gas in it. Unfortunately, I took his car, but not his advice.
What the heck? I'll get the pickup and drag you off. And it wouldn't scream at you if it hadn't flattened your tailpipe. $300.
Club. I feel so silly telling them I'm sitting in a gas station out of gas.
Maybe I could help you.
Do you work here?
No, but I've watched Wes do it lots of times. I think I could.
Well, that's awfully nice of you, dear, but I...
That's all right. Glad to do it.
Do you need some help?
I think I can manage. That's funny.
What?
Well, the gas tank on my father's car is right here.
Well, mine too. Everything's so well hidden on these modern cars, you're lucky if you can find the steering wheel.
How the heck did that happen?
I'm in the pigs. I'll get the same question.
How am I going to get that tire off? There goes nothing.
Good luck, Wes.
Come on, Pig. Don't run away. I'm not going to hurt you.
Hey, Pig. You're going sound asleep. Very sleepy. Eyelids are closing. Sleep, Pig. Sound asleep.
Someplace to put gas in it.
The engine isn't in the rear of this car, is it?
I don't think so. Wait, I'll get my keys.
Go ahead.
No, that's all right.
All right, thank you. Believe me, I'm going to pay more attention to what goes on in gas stations from now on.
Would you hold this, please?
That is, if I ever get out of this one.
Thanks. I don't know what could be keeping Wes. Not there. There it is.
Well, of all the... Now, who would ever think of looking there for a gas tank? Here, let me. Here, you hold this silly thing and let me try it.
Oh, careful of your dress.
Squeezing it hard enough?
With both hands.
Oh. Well, that's peculiar. Here, let me try.
Oh, be careful. Let's hold it. So dirty.
Anything happening?
I'm afraid not. You don't suppose the station could be out of gas, too?
Well, if there is no high test, I'll just have to use regular.
Oh, well, let me try it first.
All right.
Out of this one either.
That certainly seems odd.
I've seen Wes do this at least 100 times. You'd think I'd know. Now let's see. First he takes the hose down. And then it seems as though he twists something or
Well, what about this little thing here? It looks like a twister.
The bell!
Doesn't do any good either.
Now, wait a minute. I think he does something else. I think he presses a button or pushes something.
That was exciting, wasn't it?
I'll say. Well.
Well.
Yeah.
Easy. Take it easy.
Easy. Easy.
When I count three, I'm going to nail him. One, two, three!
Honestly, sometimes I think with all our modern inventions, we were better off in horse and buggy days. Anybody can feed a horse.
Check your... Shall I check your cars, oil and water?
I hate to ask you, dear, but Floyd gets irritated if I don't.
Wes says the same thing. It only takes a few seconds, and it may save hours later on.
That's what Floyd's always telling me. I'll show you. If you just turn this, and then... That's funny.
There was an old woman, and...
Good morning.
Had a little pig. There was an old woman, and she had a little pig. Didn't cost her very much, because it wasn't very big.
It used to open like that, I know. Maybe it's on the...
I wish Wes would get back.
There must be some way to open this.
I hate to tell him I couldn't even open the hood.
Well, just let it go. I'll tell Floyd to take care of it himself.
Oh! Oh, good, you found the latch. Where was it? I don't know.
Here.
Oh. At least I know where the water goes.
I wonder where that oil thing is.
It's under there somewhere. I'll look for it in just a minute.
Oh. What?
Hot.
Oh. I think cars are wonderful when they run, but they're no good to anyone when they don't. What happened?
Well, I got the air hose by mistake.
Oh.
Oh. Well, I think you have enough water in there anyway.
Hey, get out of that bathtub. That's for the cows.
Don't be silly. It's not big enough for a cow.
Yeah, but you're running their drinking water.
You want to join me?
Come on, look. We got to get the rest of those tires.
Okay. And it's all. Know how to wash windows.
Yes.
Hi, is Wes back yet?
Not yet, Howie.
Gee, it's after 5 and I have something I have to ask him about. Besides, the cleaners closes at 6.
Cleaners?
Yeah, that's where Wes is suited.
Oh, dear. Well, look, Howie, maybe...
Do you think it'd be okay if I spent the night at Richie Masters?
Well, yes. I don't know, Howie. You'll have to ask Wes.
But he isn't here.
I know he isn't. Oh, I'm sure it'll be all right, Howie.
Well, how about Mrs. Masters? Or do you think it'd be okay with her?
hasn't anybody asked her yet?
Well, no, not yet. Could you call her?
All right, Howie. If you'll run up to the cleaners and get Wes's suit, I'll call Mrs. Masters and find out if it's okay with her.
Okay. There, not bad.
Oh, I'll get your gift stamps.
Oh, wait a minute, I have to pay first. Oh, yeah. I could find my credit card. Will you take this?
Not down here.
That's okay, I found it. Looks like a raspberry life preserver on an old brand muffin. Boy, I haven't done this for my house since I was 10 years old.
Out, I used to think they were a terrible waste of time, but I certainly changed my mind. I practically furnished my house with them. A whole set of beautiful cane-backed wooden folding chairs so I don't have to be moving them back and forth, and all kinds of automatic coffee makers, even one for, well, this is yours, even one for Floyd's office, and mixers and a rotisserie. I think it's great fun to buy all those things I don't really need without having to spend any money.
Hey, here's Wes's suit. Isn't he back yet?
Not yet, Howie.
Oh. I don't get all these.
That's okay.
Well, his double stamp day?
There we are. Finally, all set.
What do you suppose happened?
He probably ran into some kind of trouble. I'm sorry it took so long, Mrs. Meredith.
Well, that's all right, dear. You did just fine.
Please come back sometime, Wes. Well, you know.
All right, dear. Bye-bye.
What kind of trouble? Car trouble?
How should I know, Howie? I'm sure if he had a real problem, he would have called.
Yeah, if he could. I mean, he could be in the hospital or something.
That's right, officer. A pickup truck. Would you take care of him, please?
But I want to find out about Wes.
I'll let you know what I find out about Wes. Now, look, officer. He left here at 3:30, and it's past 6:30 now. He must have gotten into some kind of trouble. He just showed up.
Oh, hey, Mr. Stark.
Did you see that lady when I came around that corner? I thought she was going to have a heart attack.
Did you see Jake? I thought he was going to fracture.
Oh, hey.
Boy, what a wild afternoon. You wouldn't believe it.
Wow, you should have seen us with a cart.
You
should have seen this boy. All those cars came flew out of that truck, and he goes tumbling out head over heels.
And we went down in his pig pen, see?
I mean, I'm taking some baths, my day, but that's one of us.
Okay to come in?
You're early.
Yeah, for a change. Hey, that's a new dress, huh? I like it. That's nice. What is it?
Probably vanilla extract.
Holy mackerel. Where did you learn to... I mean, it's wild. It's really great.
Well, it's different anyway.
Different? It's a work of art. Where did you learn how to, Boy, wait till Nora sees this. She's gonna turn green with envy.
She's already seen it.
Oh?
She did it.
Oh. Thanks a lot for holding the fort down for me today, honey. I mean, running all those errands and everything. Well, you forgot something.
What?
This.
Going. Everybody's gonna be here any minute.
Can I help?
Sure, you can. Well. All right.
Okay. Boy, that Nora's sure a wild one.
Oh? Don't forget the olives.
Oh, okay. I trust her to drive through every private property and keep outside. This side of Cincinnati. On a road that's not even an educated path.
I'll let do those. Why don't you top the celery?
Okay. Well, it sure is pretty up there. It's like being on some other planet.
Would you hand me the plate?
Sure. You should have seen that silly dame sitting in that old bathtub out in the middle of a cow pasture.
Wes, would you please answer the door?
Yes. Dun, 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 me. Dun, 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 me.
Oh, that's part of it. If you know where you're going to go, why not work toward it?
No,
why
are
you going back? You're going down one.
It's not all the way.
Jack, you go off on tangents all the time.
Please,
I do.
Please,
no. Everybody goes off on tangents.
You go down one long, narrow path.
Maybe that meant...
The nature of greatness is not to be exact. Francis Bacon.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, you're misquoting now.
Berkeley.
But the thing is that there are times when he has to go down an exact path.
He can't find anything else. They had the courage to find that.
All right, but once they find
Where is the courage today? Where is the courage in young
people
today?
We got plenty of courage in young people.
What? Where
is it? We got guys going around the world with
friends.
I mean, on the things. With the orbits and stuff. What the heck?
What happened to the philosopher?
I was getting around a country.
All right, wait a minute. What happened to every philosopher that you know? Rousseau, Voltaire, every single one of them were persecuted in their time.
No, we don't. Everybody's sitting around.
What about the pacifists who are out marching and everything?
Wait a minute. Just listen to me. Just listen to me.
But there's the proof. Well, what I mean is the individual.
Well, there are a lot of individuals who are doing that.
This country follows the same cycle of every great nation that's fallen. Every greatness, they become placid in what they have. And they sit down and they stagnate.
Okay,
and
so we have
somebody that has the energy and the power to get up and say something and believe in something.
Every new invention, every new artist, every single artist right down through history, when they broke a tradition, when they broke something that was established, this is when great art happened.
When they had the courage to
look,
do that.
Art. Now, wait, how do we get to art, officer? We're talking about...
I know, but the same thing.
That's exactly our point. How do we get to art? You see, how do we get to art?
You never think of art.
All right, just a minute. Great, so everybody goes out and thinks what they want to and says what they want to. And what happens to the rest of society?
What happened to their society? What happened to
a man like Thoreau that goes out in the woods
and you know who made it available? These guys have the courage to go out and find out.
But there was also, let me take art for instance. There is a form to art, am I correct? There is a form to art, is that right?
Yes, but
good art. Now,
now, come on.
Wes,
there's a
tell us in the follow-up.
There's a form.
There's a form, sure. There's a form because you can define a narrow direction. Sure.
One long, narrow direction.
No, there is not.
No, but you can define it. That's what I'm trying to say.
What you learned.
You can have a form, you can have technique, you can have all the technique and the form in the world and life.
Okay, but you have to learn the form first.
Take it for granted. Then it's the top and it's the intangible thing that you go with.
So it takes certain people a certain length of time. Nobody's better.
All I'm saying is people don't take the time to do that.
No,
listen.
All right, but certain people,
but how do they know?
Let's get back to what you were talking about nature. Remember you said that the throne went on.
The throne went back to nature to find what love, because life meant so much to him. It was so dear. He didn't want to find out that he was dead.
Oh,
exactly where you are.
Come on.
It is.
Listen.
No,
but what is your duty? What do you consider your duty?
My obligation. My duty?
What are you supposed to do?
Duty to what? To who?
To yourself.
To myself.
Yeah, what are you supposed to find out? You're supposed to read a book because some professor told you to read it?
I'm reading because I want to. If I didn't want to read, if I didn't want to learn, I wouldn't be going to school, would I?
But your own
choice. I went to school on my own volition, by my own choice.
I'm talking.
I wasn't pushed. I went because I wanted to go.
You don't think that the country, I told you before, this country is just following the same pattern as every great nation.
I haven't driven down that road this afternoon, but what happened if I hadn't driven down that road and what would have happened if you hadn't gone down that road to get me that whole hoorah?
Yeah, if you hadn't taken
the
chance.
Never would have happened, because you took
the chance.
Look, the party really doesn't get started until something gets broken. Come on, you guys,
that's right. Now we can go.
Come on. Now, don't get upset over a couple of broken cups. Everybody's having a darn good time. Okay?
Seems like there's more flow than what there was in whatever you spill it out of.
Here's the spot. Is there any glass over there, Tom?
What did he just say?
It's too much. That's a shame to throw this away.
It's a wild mosaic. Cookie mobile.
You got trash can handy?
Okay, I apologize.
What?
I planned it this way.
I know. Well, I mean, I planned to let you get the party going.
And I was going to take over later on for the cleaning up.
Let you relax and enjoy yourself.
Okay, so I goofed. I should have started to work sooner. What can I do?
You can light the candles on your work of art and sing happy birthday to Wes.
What? Don't worry, I'll get him back. If you let me borrow your car sometime, I'll drive it off somewhere and see where I can get it stole. When Wes comes to rescue me, we'll go tumbling down hills together and chase pigs, climb trees and jump around on haystacks and all the things that square little Irene sit by the fire hearth never has a chance to do. Not only that, I'll ask you to join us. Sometime when I'm sure you can't. You can stay in town for a change.
Wes and I can go roaring past those great, big, perfectly legible signs reading, "Stop. No trespassing. Private property. Keep out and keep your artistic hands off my..."
Will you excuse me for a moment, please?
If you can get to the mess.
Here are the records you loaned me for tonight.
Thanks, sir. Just set them down any place you can find a clean spot.
You didn't have to bring those back tonight. Well, I thought tomorrow might be too late.
It's pretty late right now. What time is it anyway?
I don't know. It's pretty late. You want some help?
No, thanks. There's plenty of hot coffee over there if you can find a clean cup.
No, thanks.
Well, maybe half a cup.
Loose ends. Boy, loose ends. You know? The day I finish anything, I'm gonna just die of the shock.
When did you start baking bread? Modeling, Clay.
Well, Toynbee, at least I finished you, didn't I? Was it the other way around? You know what I need? I need a larger wastebasket.
Nice sketch. So open, free, unrestricted.
And I'm finished. The tree has to have roots.
Smells like rain, doesn't it?
Hope so. Use a good rain.
Wash things off. Settle the dust.
Well, it's good for the trees, too.
Well, good night.
See you tomorrow.
I did an awful thing to you tonight. I know I can never take it back or make up for it or change it. I was wrong and I'm sorry, and people always say they're sorry when it's too late.
After this message, a few scenes from next week's It's a Man's World.
What? I'm sorry.
No, no, no. It's my fault. If I wouldn't borrow other people's cars, well, never again. I'm getting my own car.
What are you going to use for dough?
Well, I had that $10 I owe you for rent.
Boy,
if you can turn it into a car...
Did you set the handbrake on the Jeep?
The handbrake?
See it again, honey. You better let me.
Want to record in the little black book?
That's unpaid, Tom DeWitt. It's the thick section towards the back. You can't miss it.
What's that?
Tape recorder?
Is it yours?
Yeah, it is now. But it won't be in another 10 minutes.
Condition radiators of 14 carat pipes.
You're kidding.
No.
I mean, how did you,
Don't tell me. I don't want to know.